In 100,000 BC, the job of clothing wasn't to display wealth or sexualize the body. It was to protect the human body from the elements. Early Homo sapiens who began migrating around the world to areas with colder climates draped their bodies with various materials such as fur, leather, leaves, and grass. We all know how it went. Hunt a wild animal, skin it, and use one long piece of dead animal skin to cover your body. Boring. That is until Sir Charles Frederick Worth came on the scene. You might not know who he is, but he changed your life more than Kanye West, TikTok, and Apple put together. You see, Sir Charles Frederick Worth had changed fashion forever with a few simple ideas. He adapted haute couture clothing into more everyday garments, such as morning, afternoon, or evening garments for the wealthy and socially ambitious clientele who wanted their entire wardrobe made by Worth. He created the idea of seasonal collections and sewed his label into his garments. He replaced fashion dolls with real, live models to advertise his clothes. And he had clients come in for consultations and fittings, while also taking orders through phone or mail. You had your average person's clothing. And then, you had Sir Charles Frederick Worth's clothing. And slowly, clothing began to become a status symbol for the ostentatious and opulent. And then one day, almost 200 years later in 2024, it all came crashing down. In the end, fashion mutated into a monstrosity that collapsed the whole world's society. But there were some who saw it coming. While the whole world was having a big old party, a few outsiders and weirdos saw what no one else could. Not me. I'm not a weirdo. I'm pretty fucking cool, but we'll meet again later. These outsiders saw the giant lie at the heart of the fashion industry, and they saw it by doing something the rest of the suckers never thought to do. They looked. Did you think it was strange when a worldwide pandemic halted the economy of every country in the world in 2020 and the retail prices of designer clothing, a completely non-essential industry, went up? Wasn't that strange? No. It's rich people. Rich people will always spend extravagant amounts of money on lavish things to separate them from the poor, regardless of the world's economic status. That's the idea, yeah, but look at this. Balenciaga sold their t-shirts for $270 in 2016. 2 years later, $495. Then maybe $690 6 months ago. Now, t-shirts are over $1,000. This market won't last.
Rock bottom FICO scores. No income verification? Adjustable rates? Credit card, Apple Pay, PayPal, Klarna. What is Klarna? CA resident loans. California financing law license. Missed payment interest, late fees, cryptocurrency?
Anyone can see that there's a fashion bubble. 61% of Americans live paycheck to paycheck. The average take-home pay is flat, but retail prices have more than doubled since 2017. That means the clothes are debt, not assets. They're not investing in their style. Their style is a liability. Am I right about the fashion market? Let's find out. Look, it's two very simple questions. Is there a fashion bubble? And if there is, how exposed are the brands?
Okay, I got a good feeling about this. It's just a meeting though. People have meetings all the time. Hey, I'm Koi. I'm so excited on getting set up to become a very important client at your retail location.
Cool. So I was told by my manager to do some meeting prep, but I couldn't find any client material on you. Do you shop at our store often?
I mostly shop online.
Well, may I see some receipts or something?
Well, I usually check out as a guest.
Well, can you tell me an average on how much you spend per month?
Of course. I'm doing $1,500 on a good month right now, but I started 4 years ago with about $800 per year, so as you can see, that's pretty phenomenal returns. I just want to get a VIC status at your store so I can get access to your limited and more exclusive private sale items.
That's really cool.
Thank you.
You are under the capital requirements for a VIC status.
By how much?
$99,200 per month. And you need to maintain that spending for 3 consecutive months, so a lot.
This makes me look bad, huh? That I didn't know what the capital requirements were?
It's not great, but keep up that spending. Give us a call way down the line, you know? Okay?
Okay. Thank you.
Have a good one.
Thank you, sir. Shit. Fuck. I should have known when they scheduled a meeting with me 10 minutes before they close. Well, there is a Balenciaga collection 45 minutes outside of town. I guess I'll go check that out first. I think this is it.
What's up, man? What do you want?
I'm looking for a XXX Demna underscore fanboy 69 XXX.
Yeah, that's me.
Great. I'm Coy. I'm surveying Balenciaga collectors who have been over 90 days delinquent on their Klarna payments. I was just hoping to stop by and take a look at your Balenciaga collection and recent pickups. Mind if I take a look inside?
Sure. Come on in. Sorry it's a little messy.
Thank you.
Sure, I mean, I've missed payments before, but after I paid off my late fees and interest on those late fees, I've been making all my payments on time.
You just bought these?
Those are Acne Studios, not Balenciaga. But yeah, they fade it and wear it out before you get it.
So, it's new?
Yeah, it's made to look old, so you don't actually have to wear the clothes yourself.
I don't get it. Why are people paying so much money for these worn out clothes?
I think part of the appeal is because they have that pre-loved feel. When I wear it, it feels like I'm putting on my favorite piece of clothing that I've had for years. It's like I feel right at home.
Yes, they're very homely. In fact, on the way here, I think I saw a homeless guy in the exact same outfit. I just don't see how they can justify their price tags for this.
Well, it's really more that you're paying for a combination of certain environmental and ethical factors. Higher quality, attention to detail, better fit, and of course, brand name as well. Super 6 sweats, right? Those retailed for around $1,200, but they sold out, and now they resell for even more.
$1,200? Can I borrow this? I'll give it back.
Sure. You aren't gonna turn me in for missed payments, are you?
Nah, I don't care about that at all. This hat is actually pretty cool. It reminds me of old K-pop style hats with the little ring piercings.
That's actually called the heavy piercing cap. I think it retails for around $600.
600? What's this?
That's the Balenciaga My Name Is Demna hoodie, in collaboration with Apple Music. There are a lot of small details that make this worth $900. For example, the logo on the chest is printed.
Is that a hole?
Yeah, there are a couple, but it's intentional.
Who is Demna anyway?
This is Demna.
Which one is Demna?
The one in the black shirt.
And who's the guy next to him?
That's his partner, B-Friend.
His boyfriend?
Husband.
His husband?
Yes, B-Friend.
I feel sick. I think I gotta go.
Why? Is there something wrong?
I just came by to check some things. I'm sorry. I don't really have any more information, but I'll return the sweat soon, I promise.
Seriously, man, is everything gonna be okay?
How many t-shirts do you sell each month?
About 6,000.
What was it 4 years ago?
1,000? Maybe 1,500.
So how many of these are paid through Klarna?
Well, most. Yeah, I'd say about 90%. The late and missed payment fees on those skyrocketed a few years ago.
So, do customers ever miss payments?
Seriously? Look, if they make all their payments on time, I suck at my job.
Hold on a second. Do people have any idea what they're buying?
I focus on the strippers and SoundCloud rappers. Not one of them have good credit. And they're all cash rich. Yo, but listen. I can make $2,000 on sales commission from a SoundCloud rapper, but I can make $10,000 on commission from a Chinese immigrant. They don't even ask questions. They don't understand the rate. And better yet, they don't even understand English. Fucking idiots. Trust me, I'm not affording living here on minimum wage without immigrants. Once they figure out they're walking out with some Balenciaga, they sign where you tell them to sign.
Jesus, how did you even get into this line of work? Are you into fashion?
Nah. I'm not into that superficial, high fashion crap. I just wear clothes that I think will make girls find me attractive.
Holy shit. It's all bullshit. My eye doctor's always so busy. I just end up taking the first appointment they'll give me and then my whole day gets shot. So, alrighty. How can the value assessment team at Balenciaga help you? Well, I don't understand why the manufacturers have suggested a retail price of $1,190 for this pair of sweatpants. It does seem woefully low, doesn't it? What? No. I meant it seems exorbitantly high. Oh, well, you see, they actually have a pair of boxers stitched into the pants. Due to the intricacies that are involved with creating this pair of pants, the pricing is actually within our models. So you're convinced the underlying cost of materials and labor justify a $1,200 price tag? That is my opinion, yes. And that's a steal. If this same pair of pants were released today, they'd be priced well over $2,000. $2,000? Have you looked inside the pants? I mean, it's not even a full pair of boxers. They aren't actually a full pair of boxers, yes. But they did stitch in the top half. The genius is in the design. You see, when you wear these, it looks like you're sagging. And because it says Balenciaga right here, everyone will know what you're wearing. Couldn't you just wear a pair of boxers underneath a pair of sweatpants and sag them? Even through your pricing models, if you just bought a pair of Balenciaga boxers and a pair of Balenciaga sweatpants, it'd be cheaper. We stand behind our prices. You can afford to make less, make less. And that's both in pricing and the number of clothes you make. Nobody needs 1,000 new items a year, especially when 990 of them are absolute garbage. Excuse me, what do you think our design team does all day? That's a great question. What do they do all day? Can you name one time Balenciaga has rewarded the communities of which it both takes its design language from and markets their upcharge products to? Excuse me, I am under no obligation to share that information with you, whoever you might be. And it is not my decision. Kering is a public company. I have shareholders to appease. Are you kidding me? Really? Is that the angle you're taking? So now, any company under capitalism can't be held accountable for doing shitty and immoral things? What are you, four? Balenciaga's retails and profits have done nothing but go up. There's no way that makes any sense. There's no way that they're marking these financials appropriately. Didn't I say that Balenciaga and its consumers were clueless? Didn't I say that? Didn't I say it? I guess I just didn't realize how clueless people actually are. Everything is fueled by stupidity. Look at yourself. You know, you pass yourself off as a cynical person, but you still have some faith in Balenciaga, don't you? Do you have any idea what I'm doing? I'm betting against the entire fashion industry. If I'm right, people lose their personal sense of identity. People lose jobs, people lose homes. Nobody cares about what people are wearing anymore. They care about how much your outfit is. You know what I hate about fucking clothes? It reduces style down to numbers. I'm the head executive manager of Balenciaga's Georgia branch. Under the Caring Group.
You manage their Atlanta store?
The country, Georgia. Balenciaga doesn't have a single store in Georgia. Yeah, but there's still e-commerce traffic. I didn't realize there was enough e-commerce traffic in Georgia to manage. How much does Balenciaga do in sales in Georgia? We did about $4,000 in sales last year.
$4,000 in the entire year?
What is that, three orders? It was one order, item, one item. It was this coat I'm wearing, actually. Someone ordered this piece, the Balenciaga garderobe coat.
$4,000 for a single item?
Well, Demna has stated he wanted his clothes to be for people like himself. And it takes a lot of time and resources to design something that so perfectly encapsulates that. You have to remember, he fled a war-torn country when he was 11. His father worked in auto repair. His mother had him when she was 17 years old. He's had a tough life. Well, does Demna represent the people or does Demna represent Balenciaga? Demna represents the people.
He does.
Yeah.
But Demna doesn't have a job unless Balenciaga makes money. His job, fundamentally, at its core, is to create a desirable product that produces profit.
They've been doing business together for a long time.
And so the products that Balenciaga creates are of the highest quality and the highest value.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Are you at all concerned about how the retail prices keep rising and rising? We raise our prices appropriately to keep up with inflation and ensure all of our workers are paid fairly. But regardless, I assume our clients will continue to buy Balenciaga no matter the cost.
Okay, so let me get this straight. Demna makes clothes for people like himself. People who grew up poor, fled war-torn countries, and couldn't afford luxury clothing. Balenciaga continues to raise retail after retail after retail when their core fan base works in retail. Meanwhile, Balenciaga is having record profit numbers year after year after year, but Demna represents the people? Is that right?
Yeah, but Balenciaga doesn't target the people who work in retail.
Okay, who do they target?
Balenciaga targets the rich Chinese billionaires.
Those are the furthest possible people from Demna socioculturally and anthropologically.
They're the ones giving Demna a job. Funny, isn't it? You think logo t-shirts are parasitic, don't you, Koi? But apparently, society values logo t-shirts very much. In fact, let's do this. I'll tell you how much logo t-shirts produce in profit. You guess how much Demna's good designs produce in profit.
God, you are an incredibly big piece of shit. I honestly think the whole fashion industry might collapse. I know I've been saying the whole fashion industry's been broken for years, but it's more twisted than I could have even imagined. The whole thing's a huge Ponzi scheme with Balenciaga and Demna hand in hand at the top.
Hey, Kering Group stock continued to drop today, and Balenciaga, once the industry leader, by the way, has reported another decline in profit in this quarter's earnings calls. The company immediately fired.
Oh my God, it's starting. Their Balenciaga collections are gonna go down 90% in value. Would you listen to me? People are gonna lose their jobs. People are gonna lose homes. Well, nobody is buying Balenciaga anymore and everyone is trying to sell their collections. $50 is the new average sold price for a Balenciaga hoodie on the street. Balenciaga just closed 3 of its 5 stores in France. This thing's hitting Europe.
Employees of Balenciaga today as the giant Kering Group stock went to zero. The collapse of the venerable fashion industry titan follows a tumultuous few months of market volatility and fear in the world economy.
Being into fashion is not like I thought it would be. This industry kills the part of life that is essential. The part that has nothing to do with fashion. For the past few years, my insides felt like they're eating themselves. All the people I respected blocked me on social media. People want an influencer to tell them how to value things, but they choose this influencer not based on originality or creativity. They choose it because it seems authoritative and familiar. So, I've come to the sullen realization that I must leave fashion behind. Sincerely, Koi. We'll be right back.
Wow, I've got goosebumps.
Me too. Such a great story. I was on the edge of my seat and I was in it.
You want to know what struck me while I was watching that marvelous documentary? You can't get quality programming like that anywhere else but right here on the JBC show. You can't get The Big Cult.
Or any of these other great specials like Eternal Sunshine of the Endless Wardrobe or Good Fits Hunting.
Folks, we know you hate these constant pledge drives.
We know you hate them. We don't love doing them.
We don't like doing them either. I'd rather be at home right now, okay? Taking a warm bath with my wife.
Yeah. Oh, brother. Not this one again.
But if you want to help us out, if you want to help the JBC show stay on the air, keep the lights on, we are literally this close to losing our...